First league goal, obviously, is really, really important to score at a time when you know your team was behind. You know, what was your mindset coming on to pitch as a substitute?
I'll say guys were already working hard, you know, coming into a game like this with this kind of weather. All you have to do is just continue from what the other guy left on the field. So I came on, tried to help the team, and I was glad I got it.
Just talk about taking the opportunity, obviously. You know, getting on the pitch as a substitute means a chance to kind of show the coach what you have, and just like what was your like in terms of like making an impact? Was that just going on and being switched? We talked to Gio. He said that he was able to switch you from left wing to right wing to kind of get you a little bit more opportunity.
Well, like you said, you already know what I can do on the field, so there's not much to say about that. But I went on there trying to help the team and get it going, and hopefully get the 3 points. But too bad we couldn't. But we'll take that 1 point and then work hard, and then next week hopefully we can get the 3 points.
Jay?
Yeah. What was the mood in the locker room for you guys when going down like that on two goals that you really can't do much about when you guys create more of the chance? What was the mood in the locker room like?
Well, we just have to keep working out. That's what the information came, because as you guys said, you already saw first half we created a lot of chances. We could have put in at least two or three goals, and then that would be it for them. But they got in the game with two goals, and we just have to keep fighting. We got a goal, and we could have got a third one, but we couldn't. But we just have to build on the point, and then on the way forward, just hopefully can start winning some games at home.
So the team seemed pretty tense towards the end of the game, trying to equalize. Were you tense at all when that ball came to you for that final shot? What was going through your mind?
Well, for you guys, it could be a surprise, but for the team, I don't think it's a surprise for them, because they've seen it done a ton of times at training, so, yeah.
Oh,
go ahead, Steve.
Sorry. What do you think are some of the things that you and the team will have learned from these last couple matches that you could apply for future matches to help improve results and improve, I guess, your style of play and everything?
We just have to keep building on the good stuff, because we're creating chances. We're creating a lot of chances. We just have to find a way to win at home. For me and for the team, we just have to keep scoring. That's the problem we have. We just have to score.
Scott, can you talk to me a little bit about what was going through your head before the finish, and talk to me through the finish?
Well, as I got the ball, I already know what I was going to do, and the guys already knew it was going in, and I wasn't surprised it went in, because I've done it a ton of times in training. So.
Just one final thing, obviously, like, you know, the last couple of games at home, we talked about your home form, it hasn't been as what you wanted. I mean, just is there anything that you guys can see or feel that you can improve your home form at this point?
We just have to keep working hard, you know. We're creating chances. We just have to put them away, and then so we just have to keep working hard.
Game, I mean, battling back and getting a point after, you know, Wednesday you guys had that disappointing result to kind of get that taste out of your mouth from Wednesday night.
Yeah, no, I mean, that's definitely a positive we take from it, is that we were able to react a completely different way, you know, react and fight back, have that calmness, that maturity to fight back and get back in the game, not lose our heads. And, you know, we feel like we're disappointed we didn't get the 3 points. We feel like we did. We created enough chances to be able to, you know, still come back and win 3-2, but, you know, it is what it is now. But that's a positive we take from it, is that we had a good reaction today.
Which is much you could do on the two goals. I mean, they were just kind of just hit just super, super sweetly.
I mean, hats off to them. They're great goals. But for me, I always feel like there's something I could do. Anytime the ball goes in the net, there's something I could have done better for sure. So I'll go back and look at it and see what it was.
How was it to get back on the pitch after like the injury?
It felt amazing. Just walking out, you know, for national anthems and stuff. It just get that rush of adrenaline again. And, you know, you're only out. I was only out for a couple weeks, but it feels like months sometimes. So it was great to get that game.
Prior to this week, you guys were having a nice string of results, and then two tough games at home. Do these games feel like maybe a wake up call that you guys still have a lot more room to grow as you move on in the season?
Sure. Yeah. I mean, it's to be honest, I don't know that we were necessarily super overconfident in the locker room about it, but definitely reaffirms that, you know, we got to keep working. You know, we've been playing well. We've been getting some results. Playing well. We've been playing much better than at the beginning of the season, and we continue to do so. But you know, like you said, we definitely, you know, these two games hurt us a lot, and we got to get a lot better, that's for sure.
Yeah. Jimmy, you had the chance of watching North Carolina last week. Was there anything that you took from that game that you used here today to maybe make your life a bit easier?
I mean, yes and no. I mean, I've been playing in this league a few years now, and North Carolina has a lot of the same players. They've got a lot of guys that have spent a lot of experience in this league. So we know them pretty well. But of course, I mean, you watch them and you see how the game's played, and you're ready for how they want to set up tactically. And we were ready for them. We just didn't execute as well as we wanted to in that first half.
Overall, with the last few games between the last one and today, is there anything that you think that you and the team will be able to take and use to help you for future matches and games?
I think the biggest thing is just our how we're doing in key moments. I don't think it's anything tactically or anything, it's not like fitness or, oh, these guys are doing this or that or individually. It's just we got to step up and make some plays at certain moments in the game. That's what it comes down to when you have good teams on the field is people making big plays at big moments in the match in both boxes, defensively, offensively, just seeing what the game needs at that time and making those critical plays, those critical decisions, to prevent goals and to create goals. And that's kind of just what we're lacking, that final touch on both ends.
Obviously a good battle back to get a point here, but they're pretty interesting game because of, another controversial offside call in the first half. But can you just kind of talk to us through the game and your thoughts on what happened out there?
Yeah, just referees can make mistakes, and that was a goal, but it happens in the games. It's part of the game. I thought we did a lot of good things today, especially in the first half. I think we created good chances. We had chances the second half, but I think today, towards the second half, we just became tired. We start giving too much space. We became too open, and their counters they were dangerous. Nevertheless, we had tons of opportunities to be able to also win the game. But I think sometimes we have to see the positive side, and the positive side is that at least we found that goal that gave us a point today.
You talk about battling back. Obviously, on Wednesday you guys fell behind and kind of fell apart on Wednesday. Do you take some encouragement that you guys were able to kind of gather yourself and kind of find, as you said on Wednesday, find that discipline?
100%. I think it was very positive, the fact that we stay calm, that we continue to play, that we were relaxed in order to continue to do the things that we're doing well, and that we found a goal. We had, yes, many opportunities. Maybe some of the runs need to be better inside the box to find better chances, but overall, I felt that we had composure and we were able to tie an important match. Yes, we were tired. Some moments, as I said, we were very, very open in the second half. But overall, I think it was a good performance.
Heading into the start of this week, you guys were on a pretty good run. Do you consider maybe these two matches this week maybe a wake-up call if you guys will have much more room to grow and improve upon in the season?
I think we have to look at the three games in the way we play, knowing the results. And I felt that these three games, we were the dominant team. We were the team that had the ball. We were a team that were able to do many good things on the field. We had a solid match against North Carolina the last weekend. We played great 65-69 minutes against Edmonton. Then we lost composure. And today we can see that the two games before were heavy on us and we were tired. So I have to look at the positive side and the fact that we're playing good soccer. We're playing the way we look more like the kind of Cosmos that we want to be. I think has been a positive week. Of course, the results are not ideal.
Go ahead. Yeah. Hassan looked really good coming into the game in the second half. What do you think of his level of play and the goal that he scored?
I mean, I think we know that Hassan can bring some magic into the game. He's that player that has flair, the creativity, and he came into the match to try to bring that into it. And he found a fantastic goal, beautiful goal. When he was playing on the right side, I think he wasn't putting the type of balls that we wanted. He wasn't going into the box aggressive, and that's why I switched him with Irvin. And I felt when he went a little bit closer to the goal, then he was able to score the goal that he scored. He's a fantastic player. He has to grow in some areas. He needs to get a little bit more fit. But every time that he steps on the field, he can bring magic into the game.
fondo y siempre se resolvía. Ahora me parece, me da la impresión en esta etapa que se trabaja bien a partir de zona de volantes, pero siempre falta esa última puntada, se nota siempre. O sea, si una vez más, generalmente se equivoca el pase, eso no se profundiza como debiera ser, pero yo creo que es producto justamente de eso, porque la idea suya está clara, uno la nota bien en el funcionamiento. ¿Qué hacer para remediar eso?
Primero, no estoy satisfecho. Eso es lo principal. Cuando hemos ganado los partidos también en el pasado, en campeonatos, no he estado satisfecho. Siempre podemos hacer mejor. Y este equipo, de donde empezamos a donde estamos, de verdad que ha crecido muchísimo. Pero no podemos quedarnos en que lo que fuimos y lo que crecimos, sino que tenemos que ser todavía mejores. La idea está bien clara, al menos en este momento estamos jugando el tipo de fútbol que queremos. Pero totalmente de acuerdo contigo que en la zona final todavía hay una desconexión, no estamos compaginando con esa actez, esos pases que queremos, no estamos culminando ciertas oportunidades fáciles que tenemos, y eso nos está condicionando en los partidos, porque si tú ves el primer tiempo, yo creo que podía haber estado fácil, sin decir mucho, 4-2. Pero al final estos son los partidos, y al final estoy contento que al menos conseguimos un gol para empatar el partido, y hay que seguir trabajando.
¿Qué pasó con Flores?
Flores, el pasado partido, tuvo un problema en el hombro, se cayó, estaba muy dolorido, ayer prácticamente no podía estar ni siquiera en la convocatoria, y hoy se sintió mucho mejor, y es por eso que lo pusimos en los 18, y al final se sintió que podía contribuir, pero al final cuando entró estaba condicionado y lo vimos que no estaba dando lo mismo que nos ha dado antes, pero porque el hombro le estaba doliendo mucho.
Coach, what was the feeling for your team going into the locker room at halftime, giving up that goal so late in the first half, and kind of feeling like maybe had a couple opportunities to take the lead in
the
first half as well?
Yeah, I think the most important thing is that we had to be calm. We knew that the goal came. We knew that Lenz Lang has a good shot. I mean, as soon as the foul came, we knew that it was a potential goal. And then he ended up scoring. And for us, the most important thing is to keep composure, which we did. We came into the second half playing in the same style, with the same mentality, moving the ball around. Until a point that we missed so many opportunities and we got tired, then the game became open. But I thought that the guys today show composure, maturity coming from the halftime into the second half.
Jimmy Maurer came back into the starting lineup, made a couple big saves to kind of to bail you out. There's a little bit of some comments about his performance coming back into that. And yeah, is he fully recovered from the injury?
Right. I think he made some very good saves, important saves. As much as we had so many important opportunities to be able to score goals, Jimmy is an important player for us. He's been fundamental for this team, and now being able to play was good for him to be able to be on the field. And I think now little by little, the more he starts playing, I think the better he's going to start feeling, getting back his confidence again. But Holt did very well as well when he had the chance to play. So I have the difficult job to have to decide always who's going to play, and they make it very difficult for me.
And just one thing to follow up with, earning another goal, second straight goal. Are you seeing the kind of getting into the rhythm of your team and kind of getting into integrated into your team a little more with the second goal?
I think he looked a lot better today. He looked more like the player that we want to see in our team. He was busy. He was creating opportunities. He was strong. He lost a lot less balls. But now he needs to be a little bit better to capitalize some of the opportunities more that he had during the match. But the important thing is that he keeps us on scoring, and that's what we're asking him as a standing forward.